So today we have Howard Sumner here to show accessible voting equipment use in Bedford. The Massachusetts Election Division is committed to making elections accessible to everyone. One way that they do this is by having an accessible voting machine, and that's the AutoMark. The AutoMark displays the ballot in high contrast, magnified text, and uses audio cues. And it can also read your ballot to you before it's submitted. Howard has agreed today to come in and demonstrate the AutoMark since he uses it for the elections because he likes the independence of it and he is able to come in person to vote. So I'm going to hand Howard a ballot to mark, and this is a test ballot. He's just going to use this ballot today to show you how the machine works. In Massachusetts right now, in most elections, voters can have the choice to vote by mail, where we process a vote by mail application and a ballot is mailed to them. The state has also made vote by mail ballots accessible to people that are blind or have a vision impairment, a mobility or dexterity disability, or another disability that makes it difficult for them to mark a paper ballot. You can request a ballot by mail and it will be sent to you electronically. So if you are not able to come in and vote in person with this AutoMark machine, you do now have an option to receive that ballot by email. So that's another way the state is making voting accessible.
So once I have my ballot, which normally I would get from where everyone else gets their ballot, I put my headphones into the AutoMark machine, and then I take the ballot and I put it in as instructed. Then it'll give instructions.
Official ballot. You are voting ballot style.
So I'm going to go forward. This is a town election, and so I'm going to proceed.
Next contest. Select board. For 3-year term. Vote for one. There are two choices. Use the down arrow key to hear the name of each candidate or choice listed. Use the select key to make your selection. Use the right arrow key to move to the next contest. Use Daniel Hartley Brosgall, 57 Loomis Street, caucus nominee.
That's one.
Write in.
I'm not going to write in. But if there were multiple, I could go through them and then decide which one I want. I'll go back to.
Daniel Hartley Brosgall, 57 Loomis Street, caucus nominee.
So this is the one I want, so I'm going to hit the center select button.
You have selected Daniel Hartley Brosgall, 57 Loomis Street, caucus nominee. You have now fully voted this contest. Press the right arrow key to continue to the next screen. Next contest. Board of Assessors. For 3-year term. Vote for one. There are two choices. Use the down arrow key to hear the name of each candidate. Nicholas Stevens Howard, 7 Daniels Drive, caucus nominee. Write in.
I'm not going to write in.
Nicholas Stevens Howard, 7 Daniels Drive, caucus nominee.
So I'll take that. I'll look for that.
You have selected Nicholas Stevens Howard,
now 7 Daniels. Next.
Next contest. Board of Health, for 3-year term. Vote for two. Anita Raj, now, 4 Wildwood Drive.
Since caucus I know there's no more
candidate for re-election.
There's only one person for each. I'm just going to select this person and not go to the right end.
You have selected Anita Raj, 4 Wildwood Drive. Maureen R. Rajichi, 7 Norma Road. Caucus nominee, candidate for re-election. You have selected Maureen R. Rajichi, 7 Norma Road. Right in.
Okay, so I voted for both.
Next contest.
So it always says there's an extra choice, which is the right in.
This is the summary screen. Use the up and down arrow keys to scroll through each contest and hear your selections. If you wish to modify a selection, use the select key to return to that contest. If you are satisfied with your selections, press the right arrow key to proceed.
So I could go and review everything, or I can just proceed. I think I'm going to proceed because I'm pretty confident in what I selected.
This is the summary screen. If you wish to mark your ballot now, press the square select key. Your ballot will be marked in accordance with your selections and returned to you for deposit into a tabulator or ballot box. If you wish to change a select, your ballot is now being processed. Please wait. The printing process should take about 15 seconds. Your ballot will then be returned to you for insertion into the tabulator or ballot box. Please wait.
So now the ballot's being marked and it'll come out, and then for me, the most important thing is I make sure I brought my own headsets, so I put those away, and then I get my cane. Take my ballot. And now it's just like everybody else's ballot. So I can get up and find my way to wherever I'm supposed to go. And now I voted independently with nobody's help. And this really feels good because I'm able to vote independently.